debt, the physical debt, prevented them from continuing in office. They could not rule forever because of the physical debt. Prevented them from ruling office. But because Jesus lives anymore? Forever,
he doesn't come here.
No, he's stopped doing
he has a permanent priesthood, therefore he is able to save completely those who come to God.
He's done enough time there, he's done 20
because
years.
Because he always lived,
he's doing other
he always lived to intercede for them.
So if
Jesus died a physical death,
think by shouting he's just like he's gonna
the Levite priest. If he died a physical death, he would be just like them. That's the reason why they could not rule forever, the Bible.
Destroys any argument.
You've said a lot.
You understand that though?
Yeah, I hear what you said. Right, number one, he mentioned about Luke. At the beginning of Luke, he said, we are eyewitnesses. He uses eyewitnesses. Modern scholarship is coming round to understanding that the Gospels are based on eyewitnesses. Richard Balcom wrote Jesus and the Eyewitnesses, and it's changed, revolutionized the modern world and understanding the Gospels. On the Gospel of John, the modern scholarship is influenced by the Enlightenment. The Enlightenment, since 1700, has been skeptical. So modern scholarship has not looked at the Gospel of John with open, fair eyes. They've been influenced by Immanuel Kant and philosophy. Let me finish. The inscriptions of the Gospels, Martin Hengel, one of the greatest scholars in the Gospels, who recently died, said that the inscriptions to all the Gospels, Matthew, Mark, Luke and John, were there at the beginning, showing you that the Gospels were first century literature and that they're based on eyewitnesses because they were in that time. Let me come back to you on the book of Hebrews. The book of Hebrews, if you read it, it mainly talks about the temple and that Christ overcomes the temple, because the Jews were going to the temple, they wanted to go to the temple, and he's saying in Hebrews that Christ overcomes the temple, and in the temple there were sacrifices. In Romans chapter 3 he says we're justified by faith. It means we're declared right by God. Paul clearly built his theology, Romans chapter 5 verse 1 to 6 clearly talks about justification based on,
I don't know what I quote.
Let me finish. On Christ's death. So I've answered about the Gospels.
Let me finish.
I've answered your Hebrews. I've gone into Pauline theology. But listen, history, Suetonius, Josephus, Tacitus, we even have the Talmud. We have the Jewish Talmud that mentions that Christ was hanged, which is a synonym for crucifixion. So we have all these historical sources outside the Bible that prove and show that Christ died. That's why Dominic Crossan, who's a skeptic, said that Christ dying on the cross is one of the most well-attested facts in ancient history. And the other thing you don't know, bro, is Bob the Builder's got one of these, but I've got one now. Yeah, you didn't know that, did you? I've got one.